bless your name this evening.
We thank you this evening for the miracles you have done.
We thank you for the miracle you are doing.
Indeed, you are a miracle working God.
Lord, in this service we enthrone you as a miracle working God.
We ask you to do miracles in our midst.
Do miracles in our lives.
Thank you for the miracles you have done.
Let's lift up your voice and your heart.
Thank God for every miracle you have done.
For the miracles he has done in your life.
He has done in your family.
Lord, we thank you for every miracle you have done.
I thank you, Lord. I thank you, my Father.
I thank you, Jehovah,
for every miracle you have done in my life.
Thank you for every miracle you have done.
Thank you for every miracle you have done.
We love you, Father. Let us go to say your word and pray.
We ask that, Lord, may you lead us.
May you guide us.
Take over this session, O Lord.
We thank you for those who are here.
Thank you for those who are coming.
Lord, we pray that you bless each one of them.
In the name of Jesus,
take over this service, my Father.
Reign in this service.
Manifest your power.
Manifest your glory.
Manifest your presence.
We bless you and honor you
as we go to share your word,
my Father, and make prayer.
We exalt your name.
Blessed be your holy name,
because it is done.
Receive a glove offering of praises.
Let us celebrate Jesus.
I present the Lord with a mighty hand clap.
In the name of Jesus,
before we take our seats,
I want us to make a prayer.
We are coming to the end of the month of March.
There is a verse I was reading in the morning.
I also read it yesterday.
In the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 7 verse 8.
We are coming to the end of the month of March.
It has been a wonderful month.
It has been a glorious month.
Many great things have happened.
We are all having testimonies.
It is in the month of March
that our children have excelled in examinations.
We have received wonderful results.
And so God has done wonders in the month of March.
It is in the month of March that we have received rains.
It is a miracle. It is a miracle.
The Bible says,
better is the end of a thing than the beginning thereof.
The patient in spirit is better than the proud in spirit.
The Bible says, thou shalt decree a word and it shall be established.
I want us to decree and declare.
I am ending this month in a better way.
The end of this month is going to be better for me.
It shall be better for me in my business.
It shall be better for me in my family.
It shall be better for me at my place of work.
I decree and declare
that the end of this month of March
is going to be better for me in Jesus' name.
Just lift up your voice and begin to declare those things.
Declare for your life and your family.
Declare for your children
that the end of the month of March is going to be better than the beginning thereof.
In the name of Jesus,
Father, I decree and declare.
You have told me in your word
that I shall decree a word and it shall be established.
I decree and declare, my Father,
that the end of this month of March is going to be better than the beginning thereof. the end of this month, my Father, the end of March is going to be better for me than the beginning thereof. In the name of Jesus, the end of this month is going to be better than the beginning thereof. My Father, I declare and declare, the end of this month of March is going to be better for me than the beginning thereof. The end of this month of March is going to be better for my family than the beginning thereof. I declare and declare, the end of this month, my Father, is going to be better for me than the beginning thereof. The end of this month is going to be better than the beginning thereof. In my life, I declare and declare, in the name of Jesus, the end of this month is going to be better than the beginning thereof. In the name of Jesus, I declare and declare, the end of this month is going to be better for me than the beginning thereof. In the name of Jesus, Ramakasayama, Rapakasikalama, Rapakasikatama, Rapakasikatama, Rapakasikatama. I declare a better ending for the month of March. I declare a better ending in my family. A better ending of the month of March for my family, for dominion, for my children. I declare a better ending for the month of March, for my life, for my family. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, God. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. The end of March shall be better for you in Jesus' name. You may have gone through some struggles at the beginning of the month, but the end of this month will be better for you in Jesus' name. Tell your neighbor you are ending this month in a better way, financially, spiritually, socially, in every area of your life. Tell him, tell her, you are ending this month in a better way. In the name of Jesus, you are ending this month in a better way. In the name of Jesus, you are ending this month in a better way. In Jesus' name. We can take our seats. This is a wonderful evening. I am glad to see all of you here. It's a blessing to see you here. These rains are a blessing. They are not demonic, so we cannot begin to cast them and silence them. It is a blessing. We have been asking God for the rains. We can't complain. I am going to own a gift this evening, but I receive it as a blessing, because these rains are blessing us. So it's a wonderful evening, and I'm glad that you are able to make it to this service despite the rains. God will bless you for your sacrifice. Can you all say amen? In the name of Jesus. Let us open our Bibles to the book of Psalm 37 and verse 23. We'll share the word of God briefly. We'll make a prayer. We can read from our screens. One, two, three. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delighted in his way. Read as he gives us amplified.
Hatua za mtu zaimarishwa na Bwana, naye aipenda njia yake.
Amplified says, let us read together, one, two, three. The steps of a good man are directed and established by the Lord when he delights in his way, and when he busies himself with his every step. Now this evening, we'll be making a prayer of asking God to order our steps. But if you're writing any topic, you can write and say, why should God order our steps? Why should God order our steps? Or you can write and say, ordered steps. All that steps.
This
is what we are saying this evening. And then we shall be making a prayer, asking the Lord as we share the Holy Communion. Father, order my steps. Order the steps of my children. Order the steps of my family. Lord, order our steps as a church. Order the steps of this nation. We shall be asking the Lord to honor our steps. The Bible has told us. Let's bring back in James verse
1.
The Bible has told us in this Psalm 37 verse 23. The steps of a good man are honored by the Lord. Other version says the steps of a righteous man are honored by the Lord. And he delighted in his way. And that is why we want to ask the Lord this evening. Lord, order my steps. Many times we order our own steps. And every time we order our own steps, most of the times we make mistakes. Most of the times we make mistakes when we order our steps by ourselves. But this year we want to surrender our steps to Him, that He may order them. What do you mean by when we say that God orders our steps? What are we saying when we are asking the Lord to order our steps? What are you saying? But the word to order,
neno kuimarisha,
the word to order,
neno kuimarisha,
means to make firm and to establish.
Inamaanisha
kufanya imara na kudhibitisha.
Amen.
To make firm and establish.
Kufanya imara na kudhibitisha.
In this context,
kwenye haya mada,
when you say the steps of a righteous man
wakati nasema hatua za mwenye haki
are ordered by the Lord,
inaimarishwa naye Bwana.
We are saying to order.
Tunasema kuongoza na kuimarisha.
Is to make firm and establish.
Kufanya imara na dhabiti.
Number two, to order.
Ya pili, kuongoza.
Is to uphold.
Ni kushikilia.
Is to direct.
Ni kuelekeza.
Is to uphold.
Ni kushikilia.
It is to direct.
Ni kuelekeza.
To order is to uphold.
Kuimarisha.
To order is to direct.
Na ni kuelekeza.
It is to secure.
Ni kuweka ama kulinda.
To secure.
Ni kulinda.
So when you tell God, Father, order my steps.
Kwa wakati unamwambia Bwana imarisha hatua zangu.
You are telling Him, secure my steps.
Unamwambia linda hatua zangu.
You are telling Him, make my steps firm.
Unamwambia Bwana imarisha hatua zangu.
You are telling Him, establish my steps.
Unamwambia dhibitisha hatua zangu.
You are telling Him, direct my steps.
Unamwambia Bwana elekeza hatua.
You are telling Him, uphold.
Wewe unamwambia shikilia.
So when we say God orders our steps, it actually means that the Lord is in control of the life of a righteous man. When we say God is ordering his steps, we are saying God is in control of the life of a righteous man. He is in control. He is in charge. So when we are telling him to order our steps, we are telling him to be in charge of our lives. To be in control of our lives. That is what we are saying. Asking the Lord to order our steps. It actually means that all the stability in human conduct comes from God.
Ya kwamba uimarisho wote ama udhibiti wote katika mawasiliano na damu yanatoka kwake Mungu.
All the stability.
Kila hali ya kuimarishwa.
In human conduct.
Katika mawasiliano na damu.
Comes from the guidance of God.
Inatoka kwa uelekezi wake Mungu.
We need His guidance.
Tunahitaji uelekezi wake.
We need His direction.
Tunahitaji mwelekeo wake.
We need Him to order our steps.
Tunahitaji yeye aimarishe hatua zetu.
We are not just talking about the steps as in the feet.
Sisi atuongee tu juu ya hatua ambazo ni nyayo ya miguu yetu.
We are not just talking about the feet.
Atuongee tu juu ya miguu yetu.
We are not just talking about walking.
Atuongee tu juu ya hii hali ya kutembea.
It is bigger than walking.
Ni kubwa ama ni zaidi ya kutembea.
It is bigger than the feet.
Zaidi ya miguu yetu.
It is bigger than moving.
Ni zaidi ya kutembea ama kusonga.
When we talk about ordering our steps.
Wakati tunaongelea tu ya kuimarisha hatua zetu.
We are also talking about our decisions.
Pia tunaongelea tu ya mawazo ama
maamuzi yetu. Directing our decisions.
Bwana akielekeza maamuzi yetu.
The Lord helping us in decision making.
Mungu akitusaidia katika njia ya kufanya maamuzi.
It is ordering our steps.
Yote hiyo ni kuimarisha hatua zetu.
We are talking about our thinking patterns.
Tunaongea juu ya mitindo yetu ya mawazo.
The Lord guiding our thinking patterns.
Mungu anaelekeza mawazo yetu.
What are we thinking even right now while you are seated?
Ni nini hata mahali umeketi hivi sasa?
Is the Lord directing your thoughts?
Mungu anaelekeza mawazo yako.
Even while you are seated right now. Because I realize also people can be in a service and their thoughts are not in the service. It happens. So we are talking about decision making. We are not just talking about walking. It also involves decision making. The Lord directing your decisions. Before you decide on which business to begin.
Kabla uamue ni biashara gani utaanza.
Before you decide on which job to apply for.
Kabla haujaamua ni kazi gani nitaanza.
Before you decide on who to marry or who to get married to.
Kabla haujaamua nitaoa ama nitaolewa na
nani. Then you order your steps.
Bwana aongoze hatua zako.
Even making a decision what clothes to put on going anywhere.
Hata katika hali ya kufanya uamuzi nitavaa nguo vipi ama nitafanya kwenda mahali.
Guiding our thoughts.
Bwana aongoze hatua zetu.
It also involves our words, the words we speak.
Inahusisha pia maneno ya vinywa vyetu.
The words we speak.
Maneno ambayo tunanena.
Bible says let no corrupt word proceed from your mouth.
Biblia inasema wacha neno lolote baya lisitoke katika kinywa chako.
Let no corrupt word.
Maneno ambayo ni mabaya.
Proceed from your mouth.
Kitoka kinywani mwako.
When you talk about God ordering our steps.
That's
about the words we speak.
Inahusisha pia maneno ya
the Bible says.
Biblia inasema
let your words be seasoned with salt.
Wacha maneno ya vinywa vyako yakatiwe chumvi.
Let your words be seasoned with salt.
Maneno ya kinywa chako yakafanye mazuri na chumvi.
The words we speak.
Maneno tunayonena.
When you talk about ordering our steps.
We
talk about the places we visit.
Tunaongelea pia mahali ambapo tunatembelea.
The places we go.
Zile nafasi ama sehemu ambazo tunaenda.
Even the prayers we make.
Hata maombi tunayofanya.
Oh God, honor my steps.
Ee Bwana ongoza hatua zangu.
Honor my prayers.
Ongoza maombi yangu.
What kind of prayer you are making this place?
Je, unafanya maombi gani mahali hapa?
When Jesus was about to be crucified.
Wakati Yesu alikuwa anakaribia kusulubishwa.
He says the body the spirit is willing but the body is weak.
Alisema kwamba mwili nafsi inapenda lakini mwili ni mdhaifu.
And he made another statement.
Na akafanya akataka
it is possible to take away this cup of suffering from me.
Akasema kama inawezekana ee Bwana niondolee hiki kikombe cha mateso.
But not my will.
Lakini si kupenda kwangu.
Let your will be done.
Ila wacha mapenzi yako yatendeke.
That is God ordering even his prayer life.
Hiyo inaonyesha kwamba Mungu alikuwa anaongoza ama kuimarisha
hatua
zake za maombi.
Even the prayers we make.
Hata maombi ambayo tunafanya.
It is when we ask God to order our steps.
Ni wakati tunamuuliza Mungu aimarishe hatua zetu.
We are even telling him direct on which prayer we should make.
Tunamuuliza pia tuongoze katika maombi ya kufanya.
Which places we should go.
Mahali gani tuende.
Which places we should step.
Ni wapi tukanyage.
What kind of prayers should we join ourselves to.
Maombi aina gani ambayo tunapaswa kufanya.
It's a wider thing.
Ni mada pana.
But let us look at why God should order our steps.
Lakini wacha tuangalie ni kwa nini Mungu aimarishe hatua zetu.
Reasons why we should ask the Lord to order our steps.
Na baba ambazo tunatakana tumuulize Mungu aongoze hatua zetu.
He says the steps of a righteous man.
Anasema hatua za mwenye haki
are ordered by the Lord.
Ninaimarishwa naye Bwana.
The steps of a righteous man.
Hatua za mwenye haki.
I believe I'm talking to righteous people.
Ninaamini kwamba naongea na wenye haki.
I believe I'm talking to our holy people.
Naamini kwamba naongea na watu wa
takatifu. I believe I'm talking to our sanctified people.
Naamini naongea na watu walio
takatifu. I believe I'm talking to people who are set apart.
Naamini kwamba naongea na watu walio
I believe I'm talking to a holy nation.
Naongea,
I believe I'm talking to priests.
Naamini naongea na taifa.
I am talking to kings.
Naongea na ufalme.
People who have been set aside.
Watu ambao wametengwa.
People who have been sanctified.
Watu ambao wametakatifu.
People have been washed. A holy nation. A holy people. Righteous men and women. But the Bible says, the steps of a righteous man, the steps of a are ordered by the Lord. Why should God order our steps? Number one, to keep us from falling. To keep us from falling. Not only falling in sin, but also falling into mischief. To keep us from falling. When the Lord orders our steps, He keeps us from falling. He keeps you from falling. So why we are asking the Lord to order our steps? It's because we want Him to keep us from falling. We are always at the risk of falling. We are always at that risk if our steps are not ordered by the Lord.
Tuko katika hiyo hali wakati wetu wakati wote kama hatua zetu hazijamalishwa naye Bwana.
If your steps are not ordered by the Lord.
Kama hatua zako hazijaelekezwa naye Bwana.
You are at the risk of falling.
Wewe unaweza kuanguka wakati wote.
Uko kwenye hatari ya kuanguka.
Uko kwenye hatari ya kuanguka.
You can fall in mischief.
Unaweza kuanguka katika mitego.
You can fall in sin.
Unaweza kuanguka kwa dhambi.
If your steps are not ordered by the Lord.
Kama hatua zako hazijaimarishwa naye Mungu.
You know the place where we pray. Let us see what verse 24 says. Verse 24 says something very, very profound. The Bible says, though he fall, he shall not be utterly cast down, for the Lord upholdeth him with his hand. Can you bring NLT or any other version? NIV. The Bible says, though they stumble, they will never fall. For the Lord holds them by his hand. Verse 24 is a continuation from verse 23.
Mstari wa 24 unaendelea yani unaendelea kutoka 23.
The steps of a righteous man.
Ya kwamba hatua za mtu mwenye haki.
Are ordered.
Zinaimrishwa.
Are directed.
Zinaelekezwa.
By the Lord.
Na Bwana.
Then verse 24 says.
Kisha mstari wa 24 unasema.
Though they stumble.
Licha kwa
they will never fall. For the Lord holds them by the hand. Even if you stumble, you will stumble but you will not fall. Why? Because your steps are being ordered by the Lord. You will stumble but you shall not fall. Because the steps of a righteous man are being ordered by the Lord. So he keeps us. Why we are asking the Lord to order our steps so that he can keep us from falling. So that he can firm our steps. Even if we stumble, we shall not fall. Why? Because God is ordering our steps. There are times in life we stumble. But when our steps are being ordered by the Lord, even though we stumble, even though you stumble, you shall not fall. Why? The Lord will hold you by the hand. That's
why
you have to pray and tell God, Father, hold me by your hand. Tell him, hold me by your hand. Hold me, Lord. Hold me by the hand. Hold me by the hand. Hold my life by the hand. Hold my hand by the hand, oh Lord. Hold me by the hand. My Father, hold me by the hand. Hold me by the hand. Hold me by the hand, oh Lord. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. Psalms 121, verse 3. Psalms 121, verse 3.
Zaburi ya 121.
He will not let us be together one to pray. He will not let you stumble. The one who watches over you will not slumber. Verse, can you bring King James version? What does it say? Will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. He will keep your feet firm.
yeye ataimarisha miguu yako.
So we have seen that number one.
Kwa tumeona ya kwamba
why should God order our steps?
Kwa nini Mungu aimarisha hatua zetu?
So as to keep us from falling.
Ili atulinde tusijianguka.
To keep us from falling.
Kutulinda tusianguke.
Even if we stumble.
Hata tukijikwa.
He will hold us.
Yeye atatushikilia.
We shall not fall. When he holds us,
wakati
anatushikilia, we will not fall.
Hatutaanguka.
That is why we require God.
Ndio sababu tunamhitaji
Mungu. To order our steps.
Aimarishe hatua zetu.
Say, Father, order my steps.
Baba, ongoza hatua
zangu. Say, Father, order my steps.
Bwana, imarisha hatua
zangu. Order my steps in 2022.
Baba, imarisha hatua zangu.
In everything I do, order my steps, O Lord. Order my steps, order my steps, O Lord. Whatever I do, order my steps in this year 2022. Father, order my steps in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. Oh, okay, number two, why we should God should order our steps? Is to keep us from sliding back to sin.
Ni kutuweka tusijerudi nyuma kwa dhambi.
Or to keep us from sliding back to destruction.
Kutulinda tusijerudi nyuma kwa vitu ambavyo vitatoka
katika. To keep us from sliding back to destruction.
Kutuweka tusijerudi nyuma.
Or sliding back to sin.
Ama kurudi nyuma kwa dhambi.
People can slide.
Watu wanaweza kuteleza.
Slide back to destruction.
Kuteleza kurudi nyuma kwa vitu ambavyo vinakutoka
kwa njia. Slide back to sin.
Vitu kuteleza kurudi kwa dhambi.
The children of Israel.
Wana wa Israeli.
Desired to slide back to Egypt.
Walitamani kurudi nyuma kule Misri.
Because of the challenges they were facing.
Kwa ajili ya zile changamoto ambazo walikuwa wanakumbana.
They began to think of the food they were eating in Egypt.
Walianza kutamani kufikiria chakula ambacho
walikuwa wanakula. They were almost sliding back to Egypt.
Wakati wote walikuwa wanatamani kurudi nyuma kule Misri.
They were almost sliding back. When God orders our steps, He keeps us from sliding back to sin, sliding back to bad character, sliding back to destruction, destructive behavior, bad behavior, bad character. When He orders our steps, He keeps us from sliding back. When God is ordering your steps, you will not go back to drinking alcohol. You will not go back to smoking cigarettes. You will not go back to lies. You will not go back to gossip. You will not go back to making witchcraft prayers. You will not go back to jealousy. You will not go back to sin. When God is ordering your steps, He will not order your steps to go to a bar. He will not order your steps to go back there. You will not backslide. Let us read Psalms chapter 40 verse 2. The Bible says, He brought me up also out of an horrible pit, out of the miry clay, and set my feet upon a rock, and established my goings.
Akanipandisha toka shimo la uharibifu, toka udongo wa utelezi. Akanisimamisha miguu yangu mwambani, akaziimarisha hatua zangu.
When God orders your steps,
wakati Mungu anaimarisha hatua zako,
you don't slide back to the horrible pit of destruction.
Wewe hautateleza kurudi katika shimo la uharibifu.
Many people today are in the pit of destruction.
Watu wengi leo wako katika shimo la uharibifu.
They are in the pit of destruction.
Wako katika shimo la uharibifu.
They try to come out.
Wanajaribu kutoka.
They slide back into the pit. They slide back into sin. We are asking God to order our steps so that we don't slide back to destruction.
Then
he says, He brought me up out of the horrible pit. And out of the miry clay. And set my feet upon a rock. And established my goings. We have a rock. Jesus Christ.
Yes, to Christ.
May He establish your feet in Jesus' name. May He order your steps in Jesus' name. The rock is Jesus Christ. May He establish your steps. your steps. May he establish your feet. Psalms chapter 17 verse 5. Psalms 17 verse 5. Oh God, order our steps. Bible says, order up my goings in thy path, that my footsteps slip not.
Zimeshikamana kwa njia zako, hatua zangu hazikuondoshwa.
So he says, so that my footsteps slip not, so that I don't slide.
Kwa hivyo anasema kwamba ili miguu yangu isiteleze.
So when God orders your steps,
kwa hivyo wakati Mungu anaimarisha hatua zako,
hautateleza. If your steps are ordered by the Lord,
hatua zako zikiimarishwa naye Mungu,
hutateleza. Psalms 37, 31. The law of his God is in his heart. None of his steps shall slide.
Sheria ya Mungu wake imo moyoni mwake. Hatua zake haziteleze.
Verse number 3. To ensure that if we fall, we shall not be utterly cast down.
Kuhakikisha ya kwamba tutapoteleza hatutaanguka.
If we fall,
tukianguka,
we shall not be utterly cast down.
Hatutabakia pale chini.
I'm using the word if.
Ninatumia neno ikiwa.
I'm not using the word when. So it's not a matter of time. It's a matter of nikisema when inamaanisha una hakika utaslide. But ninasema if inamaanisha kwa bahati mbaya. Siko hapo upange kwenda kuslide. Kwa sababu kuna watu wanapanga kwenda kuslide. King James Version, Psalms 37, verse 24. Let's read that verse again.
Kala King James, Zaburi 37, mstari wa 24.
Let us read together, 1, 2, 3. Though he fall, he shall not be utterly cast down, for the Lord upholdeth him with his hand. When God orders your steps,
wakati Mungu anaimarisha hatua zako,
even if you fall,
hata ukianguka,
you will not remain there.
Hautasalia pale.
Why?
Kwa nini?
The Lord will uphold you with his hand.
Maana Mungu atakushikilia kwa mkono wake.
And make you to rise up.
Na akutegemeze, akufanye uinuke juu.
Ambia jirani yako usibaki hapo chini.
Usibaki hapo chini.
Ambia jirani usibaki hapo chini.
Usibaki hapo chini.
Ruhusu Mungu kuinua kwa mkono wake.
Ruhusu Mungu akuinue kwa mkono wake.
Rejoice not over me, O my enemy, just because I've fallen down.
Usifurahi juu yangu e adui kwa vile tu nimeanguka.
Because I'll rise up again.
Maana nitainuka tena.
Don't rejoice over me because I've fallen down. I'll rise up again.
Usifurahi juu yangu maana nimeanguka, maana nitaamka tena.
When God orders your steps.
Wakati Mungu anaimarisha hatua zako.
If you fall by bad luck.
Ukianguka kwa bahati mbaya.
You don't be utterly cast down.
Wewe hautafinyiliwa pale.
Utaanguka toko chini mpupu na ubaki hapo hapana. Atakushika kwa mkono wake na kufanya nini? Kukuinua juu. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Say amen again.
Amen.
I want to encourage somebody here today.
Ningependa kumtia mtu moyo hapa siku
ya leo. You are feeling you have fallen down.
Wewe unahisi kana kwamba umeanguka chini.
Don't remain there.
Usisalie pale.
Allow God to uphold you.
Ukubalie Mungu akushike.
By his hand.
Kwa mkono wake.
And establish your feet.
Na akutegemeze.
Allow him to uphold you.
Ukubalie akushikie.
By his hand.
Kwa mkono wake.
And he shall establish your feet.
Asimamishe miguu yako.
Can you all say amen.
Amina.
Number 4 as we begin to wind up.
Sababu ya nne tunapokaribia kutamatisha.
To give us direction.
Kutupatia mwelekeo.
Why are we asking God to order our steps?
Kwa nini tunamuuliza Mungu aimarishe hatua zetu?
Why should God order our steps?
Kwa nini Mungu aimarishe hatua zetu?
So as to give us direction.
Ili kutuelekeza.
Tell your neighbor you need God's direction.
Mwambie jirani unahitaji mwelekezo na Mungu.
Tell your neighbor you need God to give you direction.
Mwambie unahitaji Mungu akupe mwelekeo.
Even in this matter you are hurting.
Hata katika hili jambo bado na
matter you are facing, you need God to give you
direction.
We are asking God to order our steps so that He can give us
direction.
Romans chapter 16 verse 9. If you are considering to get married,
kama wewe una
ask God for direction.
Ulize Mungu akupe mwelekeo.
Seek God.
Tafute Mungu.
On who to marry. Or who to get married to.
Umoe ama umwelekee nani.
Ask God for direction.
Ulize Mungu akupe mwelekeo.
A man's heart devises his way, but the Lord directed his steps.
Moyo wa mtu ufikirie njia zake, bali Bwana uziongoza hatua zake.
It is the Lord who directs the steps.
Ni Mungu ambaye anaelekeza hatua.
You have your own desire.
Wewe una matamanio na mawazo yako
mwenyewe. I also have my own desire.
Mimi pia nina matamanio yangu.
But allow God to direct your steps.
Lakini mkubalie ama mruhusu Mungu aelekeze hatua zake.
Mara nyingi ukijiongoza mwenyewe hatua zako, kuna uwezekano mkubwa wa kukosea. Niambia jirani haya maneno. Mara nyingi ukijiongoza hatua zako mwenyewe, kuna uwezekano mkubwa sana wa kufanya nini? Kukosea. And that's when people begin saying, I wish I knew.
Ndio sababu mtu anaanza kujuta kusema, laiti ningalijua.
Kwa mfano kama ni swali la ndoa, unasema I wish I knew, na tumekuambia what God has put together, every man put aside. And in Israel, they put it in a very bad way. Wanasema, pingu za maisha. I think Israel needs help. That's how God done your pingu. Yao wanasema, I wish. Father, order my steps.
Baba, marisha hatua zangu.
As I think about my next level.
Napo wazia jua kiwango changu kijacho.
Of having a family.
Ya kuwa na jamii.
Order my steps.
E Bwana, imarisha hatua zangu.
Order my steps in my business.
Marisha hatua zangu katika biashara yangu.
In every area of my life.
Kila mwaka wa maisha yangu.
Let God order the steps of our children.
Wacha Bwana aimarisha hatua za wana wetu.
Let God order their steps.
Wacha Mungu aimarisha hatua zao.
Let God direct the steps of our children.
Wacha Mungu aongoze hatua za watoto wetu.
Let God order their steps.
Wacha Mungu aongoze hatua zao.
Don't push down their throat.
Usiwasukume
your own personal will.
Usiwasukume kufanya matendo ama mapenzi yako.
As long as they are not doing a bad thing.
Mradi haufanyi kitu kibaya.
Wangeni nataka kuuza shisha. That's why you have to stop that person. Kama kwa mentor kufanya yoga.
You
don't know yoga, don't worry. Jeremiah chapter 10 verse 23. Oh Lord, I know that the way of a man is not in himself. It is not in the man that walketh to direct his steps. Don't direct your steps. Let God direct your steps. Let God allow God to give you direction. When I tell him order my steps, we are telling him give me direction. In this matter, give me direction. Give me direction. In this matter. Number 5, as we wind up. To help us not to be overcome or be dominated by evil or iniquity.
Kutusaidia tusije zidiwa na maovu ama dhambi.
To help us not to be overcome.
Kutusaidia tusije zidiwa
or be dominated
ama kutawaliwa
by evil
na maovu
or iniquity.
Ama dhambi.
Psalms 119 verse 133.
Zaburi 119 mstari wa 133.
Psalms 119 verse 133.
Zaburi ya 119 mstari wa 133.
Let us read together, it's already there on the screen. 1, 2, 3. Order my steps in thy word, and let not any iniquity have dominion over me.
Uzielekeze hatua zangu kwa neno lako, uovu usije ukanimiliki.
Kuna watu
wamemilikiwa na uovu kwa sababu hatuwazao haziongozwi na Bwana. Hata uhubiri injili gani, hata uswet ile kitu umekataza, ndio kesho kesho anafanya kwa sababu amemilikiwa na uovu. Mungu atusaidie tusimilikiwe na uovu. Imelikuwa na uovu, acha tuhubiri, acha. Acha tulete nani? Tunamkataza leo, kesho unajikuta nani? Kwa sababu umemilikiwa na uovu. May God help us. That iniquity will not have dominion over me.
Ya kwamba uovu hautatumiliki.
Lift up your right hand, say, Father, help me.
That
iniquity will not have dominion over my life. Make that prayer. Ninaomba Mungu akusaidie. Uovu usije
ukanimiliki.
Bwana nisaidie. In the name of Jesus. So the word of the Lord is our roadmap on how to live on earth.
Kwa hivyo neno la Mungu linatuelekeza jinsi ya kuishi katika
maisha. How to relate with the others and how to relate with God.
Jinsi ya kuhusiana na wenzetu pamoja na Mungu.
David says,
Daudi anasema,
order my steps in thy word.
Elekeza hatua zangu kwa neno lako.
In other words, whatever decision I make.
Kwa maneno mengine, kila uamuzi ambao unaofanya,
let it concur with your word.
Wacha kainende sababu na neno lako.
Whatever decision I make.
Kila uamuzi ambao ninaufanya.
Every word I speak.
Katika kila neno nalonena.
Let it concur with your word.
Ikaendane sababu
na neno lako. My thinking pattern.
Kwa mawazo yangu.
Let it concur with your word.
Wacha yakaenende sababu
na neno lako. Wherever I go.
Kila ninapokwenda.
Let it concur with your word.
Ikawe sababu na neno lako.
The words I speak.
Neno nayenena.
Let them concur with your word.
Wacha yakaenende sababu na neno lako.
Order my steps in my word.
Unasema elekeza hatua zangu kwa neno lako.
That is a big prayer.
Hilo ni ombi kubwa kabisa.
Father, order my steps in thy word.
Ee Bwana, elekeza hatua zangu kwa neno lako.
This is our year of the word.
Huu ni mwaka wetu wa neno.
May God order our steps in his word.
Wacha Bwana akaelekeza hatua zetu.
I say may God order your steps in his word.
Wacha Bwana elekeza hatua zako kwa neno lako.
May God order his steps in your word.
Wacha Bwana elekeza hatua zako kwa neno lako.
May he order your steps in his word.
Wacha Bwana elekeza hatua zako kwa neno lako.
In the name of Jesus.
Kwa jina la Bwana.
So sometimes,
kwa hivyo wakati mwingine,
God has been ministering to me, I think, for a few days.
Mungu amekuwa akininenea ama akinihudumia kwa siku chache zilizopita.
That some of the misunderstandings between people.
Ya kwamba baadhi ya kutoelewana, hali za kutoelewana kati ya watu,
will be minimized or stopped if he orders our steps in his word.
Zitapungua ama zitakwisha kama yeye Bwana ataelekeza hatua zetu.
If he orders my steps in his word.
Akielekeza hatua zetu kwa neno lake.
I will be very careful with what I say.
Basi mimi nitakuwa mwangalifu sana kwa maneno ya kinywa changu.
And what I do.
Na kile ambacho ninakifanya.
We want to make this prayer as we share the Holy Communion.
Nataka kufanya hili ombi tunaposhiriki meza.
In the remaining months of 2022.
Kwa sababu katika miezi iliyosalia katika mwaka wa 2022.
May God order your steps in his
word. Wacha na imarisha hatua zetu kwa neno lake.
You require the Lord to order your steps.
Tunahitaji Mungu kuimarisha hatua zetu.
You have been ordering your own steps for many days.
Wewe umekuwa ukielekeza hatua zako kwa siku mingi.
And that is why the things are the way they are.
Ndio sababu mambo yako jinsi yalivyo.
And time has come.
Wakati umewadia.
For us to allow the Lord.
Wetu sisi kumwachia Bwana.
To order our steps.
Aelekeze hatua zetu.
We have ordered our steps by ourselves.
Sisi tumeelekeza hatua zetu wenyewe.
For many days.
Kwa siku mingi.
We have not succeeded.
Sisi hatujafaulu.
Now we are to allow him.
Sasa tunataka kumruhusu.
To direct our steps.
Aelekeze hatua zetu.
To give us direction.
Tupa mwelekeo.
Order our steps. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus.
Father, in the name of Jesus.
As we partake of this Holy Communion.
As we partake of this Holy Communion.
We pray, O God.
Tunaomba, E Bwana.
Order the steps of Dominion Worship Church.
Order the steps of Dominion Worship Church.
Order the steps of Dominion Worship Church. Begin to pray in Jesus' name. Steps of the worship church. As we pray to the Holy Communion, we pray, my Father, one of the steps of the worship church, one of the steps. pastor. Thank the Lord to order his steps. To order our steps. In his word. In his word. This is the word. Begin to pray in Jesus' name. My Father, this evening, as you pray, Jesus. As I protect this Holy Communion, Father, I pray from this evening and the remaining months of the year 2022.